A few weeks ago, I put out a video where I built an AI email assistant. And it works great, but setting it up is kind of a hassle. You have to create PubSub topics in Google and manage the API requests inside the bot. And all of that can get kind of messy. Anyway, that's the beauty of Make. Make is an automations platform with a visual flow builder. It connects to Google services, among other things, and wraps all that functionality into clean, ready-to-use modules. In this video, I'll show you how to build an agent that connects Botpress with Make. So you get all the power of autonomous conversational tool calling with Botpress and the clean simplicity of offloading the Google API usage to another app. Let's build it. So the first thing we're gonna do is make our make scenario. This is going to be the part of our flow that connects with Gmail and does all the operations with any of the Google services that we want. So we're here in my make dashboard and we're gonna go to scenarios, hit create scenario, and we're gonna keep it nice and simple. We got a webhook with a custom trigger. This is going to be what triggers from our Botpress flow to be able to trigger the make flow. The next thing we're gonna do is add a send email module from Gmail. This is gonna be a simple flow that is triggered by Botpress and sends an email, where the AI agent's role is to be able to figure out what the subject should be and what the content should be. It's incredibly simple. The point is to understand the way Make and Botpress integrate with one another. You'll notice here, it's asking you to create a connection. Basically, you have to set up the infrastructure on the side of your Google account to let Make connect with your Google account because it has to have access to sensitive scopes. We're doing something similar right now to what I did when I built my AI email assistant, except that this one has a lot fewer steps and a lot of the logic is wrapped up in the back end of Make and you won't have to worry about that yourself. There's some setup you have to do in your Google Cloud Console that handily, they have a guide for how to do that. So we're gonna go through that right now. By the way, I'm gonna leave this in the description. We're gonna go to Google Cloud Platform, create a project. We're gonna call this project Make, select this project, and we're gonna go to APIs and Services, Library. Now, depending on the project you're using, you're gonna need a different API. In this case, we're using the Gmail API. We're gonna enable it. You go to OAuth consent screen and then hit get started. So you give the app a name. I'm gonna call this make and the support email is just gonna be the email that I'm using. For the audience, we hit external. Under the contact information, I'm gonna do the same email. Agree, and then we're gonna create. Now we head over to branding and we go down to authorized domains. Now the two domains you're gonna have to add are make.com and integromat.com. Okay, now this is optional, but an audience, I'm gonna hit publish. For now, I think it'll make it easier for testing purposes. Now we're gonna head over to data access. We're gonna hit add or remove scopes. Now inside this guide, it gives you the list of scopes that you're going to need for some general Gmail operations. These are basically different operations and each one that you add allows your app to perform those operations. We're gonna hit save. Now what we have to do is create credentials so that our Make app can access the Google Cloud platform. Let's go back to the platform. So in APIs and services, we're gonna go to credentials and we wanna make a client. We're gonna hit create credentials and we're gonna choose OAuth client ID. It's gonna be a web application and we're just gonna call that Make client. Now here in authorized redirect URIs, we're gonna enter this URI. It's given in the guide. Hit create and it's been created. Now we can access our client ID or our client secret whenever we want. Cool. Now's the part where we establish the connection in Make so that it can finally actually communicate with the client we just created. So moment of truth, we go to Make, we hit create connection, connection name, give it a name. Now we show advanced settings and we enter the client ID and the client secret. So we could find that right over here, client ID and client secret. Done. Now we may have to authenticate. Looks like we will. Obviously, Google is claiming that this is not verified. You are the only one using it. You know that there's nothing nefarious happening inside of this app. It's worth noting that Make actually puts a stipulation somewhere in the guide where it says, if the app isn't verified, they cannot guarantee that you'll always have access to permanent connection to the app. So that's something to look out for. We're going to add a webhook response at the end that basically says, once this is executed, assuming it's executed properly, send the response that says, hey, everything worked out.
Hey, editing Ben over here. I had some authorization errors, so I re-added some scopes in GCP, and then I created a new connection in Make with the same OAuth client, and everything seemed to work out.
Now what we're gonna do is create the Botpress flow that can interface with the Make flow that we just created. To walk you through how this should work, in theory, we wanna have a bot that is conversational that will autonomously determine based on the user's input when to trigger the Make flow. What that means is that it will call the webhook and it will also give the parameters that are necessary for sending the email, which means the recipient's address, the subject, and the body. So let's walk through how that should work. Here in Botpress, I just have a plain, simple bot, single autonomous node. First thing we're gonna do is install the Make integration. You want to look for the one that's made by Decay. You can tell it has way more users than any of the other ones. Now, we have to give the webhook URL our make.com webhook. So how do we do that? Let's go back to our make flow. Now we add a webhook. email webhook. As you can see, I already made one, but it's as simple as giving it a name and you hit save and you get a webhook address. So we copy the address. This is just to configure the integration still. All right, it's done. Now, as you can see, it says here, it will determine the data structure from the incoming data automatically. That means it will be able to predict some type structure, and how it's going to predict that is based on whatever piece of data it gets first. So now let's build the data structure that we're going to use inside of our flow that is going to A, help Botpress understand how to format the data for the email, and B, give all the information that's necessary to make to be able to send that email. So what we're going to do is create a workflow and call it send email. It's going to be massively simple. Just add a send data card, and the data that we're going to pass it is going to be the email data. Now what we have to do is create a workflow variable here that contains all the information necessary to send that email. If I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. Botpress really thrives when it comes to passing variables with a highly enforced schema. So what we're going to do right now is create that schema. So we're going to add a new schema. We're going to call it email schema. It's an array of recipients because you can have multiple recipients. It has a subject, which is a string, and the content, the body. Save it. Cool. Done. Now in the main flow, we want to call that flow and make sure that in the email flow, we add email data as an entry variable. So we haven't actually passed any data to be sent. I think you know the answer here, but the data that you want to send is workflow.emailData. Now back in our main flow, we're accessing the send email flow. We have the AI automatically determine how to format all the different values. Now we just have to give instructions that are clear enough so that it knows what to do. So I have these instructions written here. So it just says when the user requests to send an email, execute the send email flow with the appropriate structure. And the appropriate structure, of course, is going to be reinforced through this Zot object that we created. I don't see there being any issue. So what we're going to do right now for the time being is test it out. Now this webhook over here is listening for any messages, because as soon as a message is sent, it's going to extrapolate what structure to expect. So let's deal with that. Can you send an email asking them to buy old oats? I just realized the scenario is not live, so let's fix that. So we save all these changes. Let's push the scenario to be live. And now let's try to determine the data structure. It says it's been determined. What we can see when we open our Gmail module is that the structure and the names of the keys from our webhook request are described over here. And that's perfect. That's all the data we need. So recipients go over here, subject and content, save. Now we're going to try to actually send the email. We're going to go here into Gmail. Now make sure this value over here is set to map. It's not going to work otherwise. Make sure you hit save. Now our scenario over here is running. We're going to go back to our bot and let's see if it works. Can you... Cool, it's been sent. Let's see if it worked. And what do you know? It worked perfectly. I do want to point out that in most cases, this would be a little bit redundant and overkill to put Make on top of Botpress. But in the case of Gmail, especially if you've seen my AI email assistant video, you might understand why it's a little bit preferable to have this clean make.com interface on top of Botpress that can handle the messy stuff. As you can tell, I'm super new at this, but I was able to build something reasonably sophisticated in just a few minutes. So that's it. That's how you build a bot with Botpress and Make. To stay in touch with our community, you can join the Discord. Link down below. If you want to see more in-depth tutorials of building bots that connect Botpress with Make, let me know down in the comments. If you're looking to up your game in autonomous tool calling, Andre just put together a walkthrough of Botpress's new variable management system. You should go check it out. Bye.